That doesn't, if it doesn't settle you there, but I mean, if that doesn't confuse you, now, the Anglo-Saxon terminology is so very confusing sometimes. I'm sure it wasn't to them, but it is to us. What he was trying to give us here, and this is what he did in this Revelations, he goes on, and we'll start with the first verse again. And I saw an angel come down from heaven, having the key to the bottomless pit and a great chain in his hand. And he laid hold on the dragon, the old serpent, which is the devil, Satan, and bound him for 1,000 years. That puts that area there, right? All right. Then he said, and he cast him into the bottomless pit. All of these are, remember, Revelations is not to be taken literal. It's all symbolic. Everything's symbolic in Revelations. I saw an angel come down from heaven having a key to the bottomless pit and a chain in his hand. Well, that key is a key of understanding. And the bottomless pit, what's a bottomless pit? It doesn't have a bottom to it, does it? It does not, nothing down there to hold it up. There's nothing. It's like jumping into a hole, into a well. You know how those old-timey wells used to be? I know most of you don't remember those things, but there's some here that do, I'm sure. That used to have, they used to dig down into the dirt as deep as they could, hoping they'd get an underground stream or some kind of water underground, and they'd put a bucket, and they'd dump that bucket, and dump it down in there, and then roll it back up. How many ever done that? Have you ever done that?
Yes, I have.
And what you have?
You talk about senior moments now. But anyway, you have that bucket, and
we didn't
you.
Have a crank.
Pardon?
We didn't have a crank.
Oh. Well, I'm an old Western fan, so that's what they had in the old West, you know. They had an old crank on it, and you crank the bucket back up and take the water out. Well, imagine that. Imagine this thing. Here you have this bottom well, and there's no bottom to it. In other words, your bucket drop all the way down through China and keep going. Bottomless. Bottomless pit. Well, religion has no foundation on what they believe. There's no foundation on what they believe. Because man's foundation or man's tradition is, you know, it doesn't have any substance to it. Now, what do you mean by that, Brother Zonneveld? Well, the simple reason is, think about it. How many of them agree with one another?
They don't agree. We don't either, though.
They don't agree. They don't agree. But there's no foundation into the bottom. And now the sad part about that is because there is no room within their beliefs to change. They're going to hold to what they believe in.
True.
Amen.
They're not going to change. Now, yes, we do have disagreeing thoughts on doctrine, even in the body.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That we call the body.
Yeah.
You know, let's say it right now. That we call the body. But there is one thing about the true body of Christ.
Yeah.
If there is any confusion, there is a door for God to change that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so when that happens, there are truths that are established in this group of people that we do agree on.
Yeah.
And those truths are like, for example, I don't know any of them disagreeing on the Godhead. They believe two are in the Godhead. There's no disagreement on the baptism of water. It has to be submersion.
Yeah.
Yes.
There's no disagreement on the baptism of the Holy Ghost, that you have to speak in tongues. Not, and I say that word have, but if you do receive the Holy Spirit of God, you will speak in tongues.
Yes.
That is a sign.
Yes.
It's an evidence, if we use that term.
Initial.
And that then, that Holy Ghost works in us when we have received the initial evidence. Then there'll be evidence of our lives progenitrating or generating our spirit in our walk with God.
Yes.
That has foundation. So there's a foundation in this body of people.
Yes.
There's not just a bottomless pit.
Right.
So a bottomless pit is the mass confusion of what? Of the religious ideologies. Doesn't necessarily even mean church. There are people that walk on the streets, never attend a church, that have got religious conceptions, and they're false conceptions because they regenerated through the flesh or through carnal men's thinking, or philosophers that have no concept of the natural, rather of the spiritual, but they're of the natural. We're living in a world where materialism is rising, where the God, that's a God. That's a God to be.
True.
The God of materialism, the God of atheism, there's a God of atheism.
Yeah.
That's the carnal, fleshly mind that says there is no God.
Amen.
There is a there's a the God of polytheism that is that there are many gods that they worship, that they serve, and they worship. I can go right down the line of different people, or rather of different religious ideologies that are in the minds of fleshly men and women. The God of materialism points out that we're created, we're born into this world, and the world formed itself, and it come into formation, and man is in formation, and the fact that that is, that's God. That's God. That happening is God. That area is God. Then there is another form of belief that folks have a concept of this type of belief, that there is a dualism. That's one religious, or rather false thought of the Godhead. That there's a dualism. And that dualism is that there is a God of evil and a God of good.
Yes.
And that God of good and God of evil causes havoc and causes confusion, and it doesn't matter. It's just the way people are when they're out doing things, and they're doing causing hurt, they're causing pain, they're causing excessive trauma in people's lives. That's just the way they are. Accept it. That's the way they are. And that's what this world is confused, that mass confusion is in this world.
Yeah.
I am glad that I have a key or an understanding of that bottomless pit.
Amen.
Blessed be the Lord. How many are glad you understand that?
Thank you, Lord.
I have to understand all of that. Now, that doesn't mean that I am dogmatically coming at opposition to that, because that is where the mistake is made in the human thinking, that we are to rise up and we're to speak out against it, and we're to talk about how evil they are. No, that's not it. That's not it. That's not anywhere near it. But I have to learn to recognize what is truth and what isn't truth.
Amen.
Yes. I have got to see that.
Right. Yes.
I've got to understand that.
Yes.
I'm not critical of any group of people.
Good. Good.
But I will say this, that I recognize what is truth and what's not truth, because I've got my footing and my foundation here in the body of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank God for this group of people.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord. I wouldn't see this. I would be just as blind as the next fellow if it wasn't for the fact that God called me out of the world and allowed me and allowed my parents, not me. I was born in this naturally.
Yes.
as well as spiritually. My parents migrated and gave up their home. They gave up their income. They gave up their jobs. They gave up everything that they had and packed what they could in an 8x8 crate. Why? Because they wanted to move here and be a part of the body of Christ. Blessed be the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
That was their motive. They didn't come here to get rich. My daddy took a job pushing a lawnmower, making $25 a week when he worked for the Postal Service in Amsterdam, Holland. That's what he did. He came here and took a job pushing a lawnmower. And he didn't even know whether he had a job or not, because there was something in his heart that drove him and said, I have got to be with the people of God. Blessed be the Lord. Wonder how many people would do that today.
I believe I would. That's it.
Pardon?
I believe I would.
I believe you would too, Mom.
Yes, I do.
Give up anything to be with the people of God. Yes. That's what it's got to get to.
Yes, it is.
That's exactly what it's got to get to.
Yes, it is.
A good example of that is Abraham. God said, I want you to go. I want you to go to the land.
That's it.
And I want you to possess that land.
Yes.
Abraham didn't even know where he was going.
No, he did not.
He didn't even know what God was talking to him about. But he had enough confidence in God that he packed up his crew and he said, hey, we're going on a trip. Let's go. Yeah. Because he had faith in God. He had his mind made
amen.
Up. Okay. Now, having the keys to the bottomless pit, saw an angel, having come down from heaven, having the keys to the bottomless pit, and a great chain in his hand. What if I were to tell you this chain that is typed here has 144,000 links in it?
Yeah.
That chain has 144,000 links in it. Because where we're speaking from now, at this point of history, And the sequence of God's timing is that here, this is right before the right before the 1,000-year reign of Christ. This is where it starts. In fact, actually, figuratively, it starts the 1,000-year reign of Christ. That's the area that we're dealing with right here. And he laid hold on the dragon, and look at these terms right here. If you have your Bible, you ought to underline these terms, because these are identifying terms of the operation of man's flesh. These are identifying terms of the operation of man's flesh. The serpent.